Gaelic Naismith made a name for himself at Accrington Stanley, still only 26. The Scottish attacking midfielder is a comparative veteran with 208 first-team appearances to his name, a career which began at Rangers and has taken in stops at Cowdenbeath, Bezirk, Accrington and Hartlepool along the way. Naismith brings his laid-back conversational style to this week's Sky Bet EFL Q&A and offers a calm perspective on football life. He reveals that his hero is Paul Gascoigne, that he likes a bar of chocolate to accompany a cup of tea, and that he has uncomfortable memories of Plymouth's home park ground. "Were you always an attacking midfielder?" "No, I wasn't. I started my career as a left back for my boys' club, Team Rangers Boys Club. When I signed for Rangers initially, I was playing left back then as well. I've kind of moved up the pitch from there. I was about 16 when they moved me up. I always attacked from left back and scored goals anyway. So if you've got goals in you, you just get moved forward. I even played a few games up top. Best moment on a football pitch? I've been fortunate to have had a few good moments, so I don't know which one to go for. It's tough. My debut at Ibrox Park for Rangers, my first start, was on Remembrance Day, and I think the crowd was 40-odd thousand. And that was for the team I supported as a kid, so that was amazing. Gaelic Naismith scored 14 league goals in 73 appearances for Accrington. Maybe my attitude could have been better towards certain managers in my younger days. When I was at Rangers and then on loan at Cowdenbeath and Partick Thistle as a 19-year-old Cal Naismith, then there was Notts County, away last season when we won the game, 3-1 in April 2017, and found out we were promoted. But I'll probably save the last game of the season when we won the league on the last day just to top everything off. He scored 2 in a 6-1 home win over Cheltenham in May 2017. It was very unexpected. We just quietly went about our business and things just kept falling for us. Other teams around us were slipping up. It was crazy that we won it on the last day, but there's no better way to do it, I guess. It was some day. We won 6-1, the sun was out, the crowd was unbelievable and everyone was on the pitch at the end. That was a great day. Is there one regret you need to put right? No, I try and have no regrets. When I was younger, I was a little bit immature, and looking back, maybe my attitude could have been better towards certain managers in my younger days. When I was at Rangers and then on loan at Cowdenbeath and Partick Thistle as a 19-year-old. Now I understand more about the game and how tough it is for managers. I guess it's all part of it, all part of the journey of growing and learning. I'm happy with the stage I'm at now. It wasn't my attitude directly towards my managers. I just feel I could have maybe listened to them more. Even my coaches at Rangers, they pulled me in and they were always trying to help me, but when you're a young lad, you always think you know better. It's only now when you look back and you think, they were right, they were giving me the right advice, I should have gone with it. I didn't listen to some of it, but there's definitely more I could have learned and even gone to them at times and said, right, what can I do to make myself better at this and that, and then follow their advice to try to make myself a better player now. That's the advice I would give to young kids. Take everything in at 16 and 17. Gaelic Naismith. Regard Lionel Messi as the best player in world football, there have been loads. I've not got a very good memory, so I'll take one from this year and go for the lad Curtis Nelson, who's center back at Oxford. I played up top in that game and he was tough to play against. Strong. Quick. He's a good player. He was captain at Plymouth, he's the Oxford captain now, and I can definitely see him going higher than League One. I don't know him personally, but I think he's been unlucky with injuries this season. When I've played against him, he's definitely had all of the attributes. He's strong, quick, good on the ball. I didn't give much time and space when the ball came into my feet, and then when you try and spin him and turn him to run in behind, he can also cover the ground well. Least favorite away ground. I don't like Plymouth. It's a good stadium and good atmosphere, but I don't think I've ever won there. Maybe a draw, but the game that rings a bell is the playoff semi-final with Palmby when Plymouth scored in the last minute to knock us out of the playoffs, a 1-0 defeat, 3-2 on aggregate in May 2016. That was a tough one to take, so I'll go for Plymouth. Hopefully I'll put things right when we play there in a couple of weeks' time. We're both going for the playoffs. They've had a run of good results and they're in great form, so it'll be a good game, although we can't really think that far ahead. What's your guilty food pleasure? Chocolate. A cup of tea and chocolate, you can't beat that. I love dairy milk, fruit, and nut. I ration myself, but maybe on a Saturday night I'll have a bigger bar and a cup of tea. It all depends how I feel. I try and stay off it, to be honest, but I'll have it probably twice a week. I'm more likely to have it if we've won. That's a tough one. It's hard to think of one thing. I've played with a lot of characters, a lot of funny lads in the game. It was a top changing room when I was at Accrington Stanley. There were a lot of characters in that one, like Adam Buxton, who I've played with at Accrington and also here at Portsmouth, now at Tranmere. Tom Davis, as well, now with Coventry. They're both just quick-witted, funny people. Boyhood sporting hero. Paul Gascoigne. He was at Rangers and one of the first DVDs I had was a Paul Gascoigne DVD. I literally used to tell my mom to put it on every night when I went to bed, and I used to watch it, the same DVD, over and over again when I was a wee boy. I love it the way he was. He played football and he took it seriously, but he also had a laugh with it. He had a smile on his face and didn't take it too seriously. I feel the game is taken a bit too seriously nowadays. You can't do anything, or say anything, whereas Gazza had a laugh and still lived his life. And he was unbelievable on the pitch. He was a character. I've heard a load of stories about him. My manager at Rangers was Ali McAllister, and because I loved Gazza so much, I just used to ask him, "Tell me stories about Gazza, tell me stories about Gazza." And he'd tell me a million different stories about him. Does it sound bad if I say I'd take away the protection for goalkeepers? I like goalkeepers. I just think they are protected far too much. They can come out with their studs in the air when they're catching balls, but then if we run into them with our studs in the air, it's a whole different story. I think that goalkeepers should be protected like every other player. One touch and they go over and it's a foul. I don't like that. Most embarrassing moment in football. Newport away last year, which was a massive game for us in trying to secure a playoff spot and to get promoted. I think it was 2-1 to Newport at the time, and we got a penalty with a chance to make it 2-2. I missed the penalty, put it over the bar, right in front of the Portsmouth fans. That was a horrible moment. Pretty embarrassing at the time. It was a terrible penalty. I just floated over the bar. But then we bounced back, got it to 2-2, and I scored the winner to make it 3-2. So it wasn't all bad in the end. Which player in history would you like to play alongside? Obviously I'd love to play with Gazza, but I think I need to say Lionel Messi, then I could say that I've played with the best player of all time. I would just tell him to do whatever he wants. I'd love to try and get the ball and pick him out with a pass or two. Even have him pass to me once. That could be my claim to fame, that I've played with Messi and he passed me the ball. That's the thing. He is a team player and he's always looking to play the bounce passes with teammates. 190 minutes, I'd even take just 45 minutes to be on the same pitch as him. Think fast, act faster with Sky Bet's new in-play features. Get the full picture faster with every live score in one place, grouped by competition on the UK's number one rated iOS betting app.